Well, hi everyone, Phil Camden here. Happy Easter to you all from Lenore and myself, and I hope you have a safe and a wonderful holiday season. You know, it's Good Friday today, and I want to talk about a topic that I've become very intimate with. If you like, intimacy means into me see. And I've gone into this topic over the last 7 years on a journey with many people, including myself, and that is the topic of death. Now, don't turn off yet, because it's something that 100% of us are going to have to face. And what we're celebrating this weekend is actually victory over that very enemy that is death and dying. You know, if there's one thing that COVID-19 has taught us, it's this: none of us, including myself, none of us want to die. In fact, we'll do anything we can to starve off the process of dying and entering through that door of death. You know, whatever it takes to slow it down, we'll eat well, drink water, exercise, take vitamins, prayer, meditation, just to name a few. We'll go through and we'll seek medical care. We'll have operations to remove cancers. We'll invest heavily in research for cures and discover antibiotics. We'll isolate, we'll distance ourselves. We will do, all of humanity will do whatever we can to slow down the process of death and dying. And that's all good and well, you know, and this is right because life is precious. Life is short. Life is wonderful. Life is fragile, and life is worth fighting for. Like many valuable things, the value is derived from its fragility, how fragile life is, how scarce and limited life is. And you know, who would have thought that a small virus in our body could bring the whole world to our grinding halt? You know, it's confronting. It's a reminder that sooner or later we will all be evicted from our bodies. And can I say that all of this slowing down process of death is well and good, but if we haven't dealt with, and we will eventually have to deal with, the reality of death, then the slowing down of that process really hasn't been of any eternal value. Most people live this life like it will never end, and we prepare for the next life like it will never begin. But death comes to all of us, whether we prepare for it or not. And so I want to talk to you today about the answer to the stress that death brings into our life, and peace and joy in every circumstance is one of the greatest defenses against stress, and one of the greatest things that we can have in our life, peace and joy, to slow down the process of dying in our lives. Now, it's peace and joy in every circumstance, not peace and joy for every circumstance. So people ask me, you know, what do I think is the major reason for me doing so well in this motor neuron? Remember, it's a terminal illness. There's no cure. They told me that I would be dead 4 years ago, and I'm still alive and enjoying life right now. And so the questions are coming to me. What do you think is the biggest factor in slowing down the process of death? And I know that there are many. A lot of people are praying for me. I'm doing the vitamins, all of those things. But dealing with the stress of death is one of the major factors. And I can honestly say that I have peace and joy in the pain. And you can too. You know, it's a dichotomy, but it is possible to live life fully present with peace and joy while understanding that death is just a heartbeat away or a breath away. As a Christian, we believe that death has lost its sting and the power and its power when Jesus Christ died and rose from the dead. Victory over death is through faith and trust in that reality that 2,000 years ago, Jesus died for our sin, rose again, and now we, through what he did and faith in what he did, can have eternal life, not by works, but because of the benevolence of God, the mercy, the kindness, and the love of God. This is why we celebrate Easter, as a reminder that Jesus died on Good Friday, rose again on Good Sunday, making it possible for all who believe in him to have eternal life. to go from from earth to heaven, from corruptible to incorruptible, from mortality to immortality. We actually begin that eternal life right now, this very moment, the very moment we accept for us personally what Jesus did on the cross and rose again. Was for us personally, that very moment we enter into eternal life. We're not waiting to die to enter into that. This life is just a part of the eternal life. Death is just a doorway into that heavenly place. Paul put it this way in Philippians 3:20. He says, we are now already a colony of heaven living on earth. Get that? We're already, right now, a colony of heaven. We are citizens of heaven living on earth. And so peace and joy is found in the reality that death has been defeated, offered to all of us because of God's kindness and love and benevolence. And so, you know, when we have peace like this, it creates a different prayer language. My prayers are not defensive or demanding. I demand healing, God, I demand this. My prayer life is now a depending, a hope-filled and a trusting prayer life. It's saying, God, I trust you. It's not telling God what he must do, but believing that God will do the right thing by me. It's trusting from a place of peace and believing God is faithful. Our stress levels drop, and we know the worst that can happen is also the very best. That while we do all we can to live and love life, it comes from a place of victory, of trust, of hope, of faith, that death has been conquered. Our prayers don't come from a place of stress, but of rest. And as a Christian, I want to tell you, I believe that Jesus Christ has defeated the sting of death. He's taken the penalty of our sin, which is death, and he's bore it upon himself. And because of that, we can have eternal life. Heaven is a reality where there is no pain, no tear, no sorrow. Gone will be the nights filled with terror and fear and violence. Gone will be hunger and thirst, not even a memory. Heaven will be a place of endless joy. And so the Easter message is a message of hope, and it does change everything from now until eternity and beyond. So happy Easter, everyone, and more peace and joy with less stress to you. God bless you. Have a wonderful weekend.